Hello, map makers. I'm excited today. You want to know why? Because we're going to draw a map. What do you say we get started? I don't have, admittedly, too terribly much of a plan. We're just kind of going to draw to our heart's content and see what happens. But I'm going to use my usual formula between zigs and zags and going here and there. I think we're going to have the tip of our place in the south. Look at that. I'm going to make it nice and wide. Nice and wide. Maybe we'll end it right there. That gives us a general idea. Before we go any further, I have been meaning to make the compass as well as the title of the map right off the bat, and I haven't been doing that. Naughty, naughty. That was all right. Looking good, looking good. Let's grab my nice little stencil here so I can make a perfect circle. Coffee. Try and line it up as perfectly as I can. It's a little off. Let's fix that, shall we? And that's better. I'm gonna fill that in anyway. Okay. In fact, why don't I do that right off the bat? Just coloring in this compass. And you know, for the most part, it's nice to do the aesthetic things after the little things, but I'm partly doing this because I want to get the most clear image as I can of what this circle looks like and its better measurements. And fill it in a little bit like this. And I'll just color the whole thing. Why not? Usually, yes, you don't color things in with a pen, but for the sake of having everything the same exact tone, anything filled in is going to end up with pen. the old pen. I wonder what that looks like on the next page. That's fine. Done with that. Coffee. The life's blood of my adventure here. I kind of caused a problem for myself because now I don't have the best guide. No. Outside of the point to the tip, the tippy top. Right there, just like that. And I don't mind if they intersect with the circle a bit and cross, or filling in a bunch of them. Alright, that looks pretty good. Let's get those micro measurements. fill it in a bit. Oh, I colored the wrong one. Darn it. I was wondering what was going wrong there. Oh, well, I'll fill it in somehow. I'll make it work. Alright, now that this little thing is here, I need to figure out how to incorporate that somehow. So I'll just do a bit of this. That looks neat, doesn't it? Kind of looks like a bit of a shadow. Yeah, I'll take it. And then we do north. South. Didn't leave myself much room there, did I? West. East. And I'll have the title of my world. Let's see, where do I want it? I suppose in the corner here. What do we want to call our map? How about we'll call it Sir Ripped. Ripped. And I know I'm crossing the line here. Riftara. It's a little messy, but that's okay. And we'll say these are like wastes, you know. All right, let's draw some islands real quick. I think, one right here. Ooh, bless you, happy. And I'm gonna draw an island like right here, but I want to draw the villager, whatever, first, and then draw the island around it. I'll just have to remember. This will be called like the Wastes. Trying to label more things, you see, rather than just, settlements. Order. Those the boredom. biggest riffs I've seen. It's just barely not going to intersect perfect. Borden Mountains. And it occurred to me that I spelled isles wrong in a recent video, so I'm just going to call them islands from now on. Refs Narthanae Mountains. Let's have a forest here. Call it Ginja. So I actually had to look it up. I paused to look it up. That is right. It just looks wrong for some reason. Maybe when I add serifs. I love my serifs. It really does change the difference from Comic Sans to something just a little more sophisticated. Maybe not quite Times New Roman, but it's the most subtle difference that makes all the world. So there's going to be a giant forest there. And what other ones do we want? Until I label rivers, there's not much I can, hills somewhere. Nardar. Sure. The Nardar Highlands. Kind of lowlands here, I guess. None. Ten. Some letters there. Nentinos. This is, in case you haven't kind of assumed, this is going to be one kingdom. Maybe the highlands and lowlands needed to be united. When I say, you know, united. And that is to say they've conquered each other. Trying to draw them smaller, you see. Sometimes give them some more character by adding little scenes too. Can we call it Yend, I'm calling. I forgot flags. Who knew? kind of inland there, I guess. I have a castle here, kind of a port settlement. What do we call it? Portra. There we go. And I gave it flags this time. It's just called Ren. This one will be called Lect. This one will go right here. Called Muna. Gonna give them all little chimneys. Pima. Yeah, sure. Glenn. Rit. In the lowlands, we got some friends, our cousins. Call it Nenin. And we'll have another city over here. Sorry. Alright, so there are kids outside who like to admire the cats that sit on the shelf by the window. Shelf that I built from hand by scratch. It is ugly as sin, but I am so proud of it. Garp. This will be Mel. Henna. There'll be a castle here. Scepter. So by the mountains, those are important. Gimma. Cello. Let's get a village here. Here. And how about a city on the river? City inland, yeah. Call it. Fell. And it's gonna have a village here. Lem, with two M's, no less. Barra. Will be lipped. Gren. This one doesn't, these don't have names. Kara. Minar. Sal. I'm almost done with my coffee already. Okay. Let's draw some mountains. It's about time, right? These are going to be some big mountains. Wide mountains, I guess. In hindsight, I kind of wish I drew them a little smaller. Or the font was a little smaller. mountains are much smaller mountains now as they shrink a bit. No, these mountains are big. Yeah, real big. I'm gonna draw some smaller ones around it. Fill it in a bit. Okay. How about we draw some water streams now? This is gonna be kind of a swampy. No, what is it called? When it's. Nah, whatever. That looks terrible. How am I gonna fix that one? It's just muddy, I guess. Let's draw the hills. So this is going to be a very water collection based area. We're talking lots of swampy areas. We'd have more areas breaking off like that. I wanted to draw a city here on our pretend island right now. And there will be another one right there. We'll call it Gaga. Draw some trees there. Some nice palm trees. It's a very nice beachy location. Okay. What else can we do? So I wanted to draw more rivers, right? This one's in a river, or a lake, I mean. Now we draw trees. And they're just going to draw the outline of where I want my forest to be. I'm kind of drawing to the lowest, then I'll have trees. More guys there. Kind of around, congregating around the mountains. Quite a bit. I'm gonna try and make some areas more dense than others, and I'll draw the outlying trees later. I've resolved to make an effort to allow more white space in my maps so they're easier to look at. And I always talk about the representation of things rather than a realistic depiction. So even though there are woods everywhere in a medieval fantasy setting, I want to make it look like some areas are simply more dense than others. A couple more. Let's make it look real convincing. Yeah. Couple more outliers. A little more dense in the middle. Along the riverway. We're gonna have this area be grassland. And these are gonna be very sparse grasses. more village there. It's gonna be called Pask. Let's draw some little embellishments. These are wastes, so really mostly void of life, and there will be dunes represented by these single peak hills, kind of. And we'll call this piece over here on. They know who they are. They're called a Darlia. Daria? Yeah, Daria. I forgot the L. What else can I draw? What else can I draw? It's kind of it, isn't it? Oh, no. Coastlines. I always do that. My return viewers know that coastlines are my absolute least favorite part of this process, but I do it anyway, because it just looks so darn good. Those islands in there. Sperrier Island, Mel. Thank you. I'm trying something a little new. It might be quicker, but it might not be. That is to say, just kind of going over it very roughly. All right, folks. And just like that, I think we have a finished map. I hope you enjoyed watching, and you'll comment what you enjoyed or whatever tickles your fancy. In any case, have a good one.